Hi everybody, thanks for coming. It is an honor to be part of ChaosConf 2018. So the title of my talk is Hot Recipes for Building Chaos Experiments. Nice to meet you. I am Yuri Niño. I work as DevOps Engineer for Aval Digital Labs, a company in Colombia. I am Chaos Engineering Advocate in my country. I love designing experiments, breaking software applications, and solving resilience issues. So in my free time, I enjoy cooking and hiking. So recently, while I was working in my kitchen, I thought that cooking and chaos engineering have a lot of things in common. They are a combination of art and science. For example, when you are practicing chaos experiments, you should be careful choosing fresh ingredients and managing failures. So with these ideas in my mind, I asked myself why not to write a cookbook about chaos engineering. So that is how I started this project, write a cookbook about chaos engineering. So for doing so, I checked my mom's recipes, my mom's cookbooks. So I added chaos principles and the chaos maturity model documented in the first chaos engineering book. So it is a result, a template for doing chaos experiment. It is inspired in a recipe. In this case, I have included the ingredients, a method for doing chaos experiments with the steps, and I also included classifications according to the chaos maturity model. So if you remember, the chaos maturity model has two metrics, sophistication and adoption. So in this case, a recipe is elementary if the experiments are running manually and it doesn't run on production. So when the experiments have methods and processes fully automated, it is classified and advanced. Something similar happens with adoption. When there are a few systems covered with chaos engineering, we are talking about in shadows level. And as you progress involving people, sponsors, and processes, the recipe reaches a cultural expectation level. So here we go. For this afternoon, I have prepared three recipes. My first recipe on my first course is for attacking an application. My second recipe is for attacking infrastructure. And finally, I included a sweet dessert for doing observability. So my first recipe is for attacking an application, as I mentioned. And it is classified as simple because it doesn't run in production and in an investment level. So in this case, this recipe is for applications implemented in Java or Kotlin with the Spring Boot. So in this case, the ingredients are one whole Spring Boot application, one theory of Chaos Monkey for Spring Boot, the dependency, and the steps are place the application in a bowl, add Chaos Monkey for Spring Boot dependency, mix them strongly, add configure and extract like this. So latency is very spicy for that, but you can choose between drawing exceptions or killing applications. That is possible with dependency. So finally, launch an attack, test answer, enjoy seeing the logs in the console. So my second recipe is for attacking the infrastructure. So in this case, the recipe is classified as sophisticated and in adoption level. So the ingredients are whole application running and one Gremlin account and installation privileges for installation. In this case, I'm using Gremlin, the Gremlin console. So the first step is take your application privileges for adding the Gremlin account. This command works perfect if you are running your application, for example, with Amazon Linux. So the second step is mix them with the Gremlin account in order to have access to the Gremlin console. And this command works perfect for this. And finally, cook an attack, test answer. Enjoy seeing the results in the Gremlin account. So finally, you can complete these recipes with a dessert. In this case, my dessert is inspired in the observability. So I have chosen Datadog, but there are a lot of flavors in the market. So spread your creativity configuring dashboards like this. So that is the result, for example. Finally, the best time to learn about fire is when you are fired. That is a quote from Jen Hammond or from your relic. Thank you.